Ooh, check this out. Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today we're going to be unboxing and reviewing the MOUNTDOG Professional Tripod. They did send me this product review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this item or finding out more about it, the link to it will be in my video description below. Please go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from there. Here's how it comes packaged in a really nice retail box, guys. Looks really cool. You can see their logo on the side, and we can learn about some of the great features of this tripod right here from the front of the product packaging. Now let's go ahead. Let's look at the package contents. Here are all the package contents. First up, we got a nice traveling and carrying case for you. We have your user manual as well, complete in multiple languages, walking us through all the great features of this tripod. Quick release plate, ball head mount, we got a center column locking knob, angle locking knobs, you got a nice center column as well running down the tripod with a counterweight hook at the bottom. We have spiked rubber feet and a couple of flip locks as well on the tripod. Here is the tripod right here, guys. Very lightweight, made out of aluminum, weighs a little bit more than 2.5 pounds, can expand all the way up to 55 inches, has that 360 degree ball head for us with a quick release mount adapter as well that we can see has a built-in level with the 1/4 inch thread on there as well too. Very universal for your cameras. This is a 2-in-1 design, so we can actually use this as a standalone monopod as well. And this can support macro photography as well too. So you can see here at the bottom, we got that counterweight hook for us as well. So really nice design, guys. Really cool tripod. Look at it unfolding right here. That's those nice angle adjustments that we have right there. So we could set that in place, but it looks really nice. Really cool. We can focus in up here for a second. We got that 360 degree ball head right here. Really cool, guys. Great for panning, that sort of thing, if you wanted to be able to use that. Then we got the quick release plate right here as well. So now let's look at this in a little bit more detail. So we got a close-up of the quick release plate and adapter right here. We can go ahead, just unscrew that. We could take our camera off, put it back on, and we're all good to go, guys. Got that nice built-in level as well. You can see the 1/4 inch thread right there. On the back side, we actually have a nice adjuster that comes out as well too, to make it really easy to thread it on and off of our cameras. And again, just twist that back on and you're all good to go. So now we can look at the 360 degree ball head right here. First up, we got the pan adjustment right there, so we can loosen that up. And then we can just rotate this all the way around 360 degrees. Then we got another knob right here that helps control the top of this for the actual ball head right there, locking it into place or releasing it. And same with this back knob as well. That affects how far you can move this and if you really want to lock the ball head into a certain position in place. Now we can take a look at your center column height adjustment knobs right here. We got two of them. So the first one adjusts the height right there, and then you can lock it back into place or tighten it back down so it can stay like that. Then we got the middle knob as well in the center, so you can see the two positions that we have here and when they're fully extended. And again, same thing, then you can just tighten that back into place, or you could loosen it up so we can push everything back in and have it nice and compact again. And then we got the angle adjusting legs right there as well too, so that's really cool, guys. Then we can see further down at the bottom, we got a nice built-in Allen wrench if we ever need to make any adjustments on this tripod. And then we can extend all the legs out if we want as well right there. So it's got a lot of different controls for us to be able to get the exact height that we need to make sure we get the perfect shot. Now let's get a camera and set this up. So I have a Panasonic G7 camera right here, and we have the nice quick release base that we're gonna install on this threaded spot on the bottom of our camera. So you can see, we just wanna line it up and start twisting it into place. Now I got everything how I want it. We can just get it nice and snug. Then we can just go ahead and push that little flap down. We're ready to add it to our tripod now. So there we go, just quickly put it in place, tighten it back down, and voila, look at that. All good to go with this nice ball head right here. I gotta say, the pan movement is very fluid, so really nice, guys. Love how that feels. Looks really good too. Now let's go ahead, let's configure this for macro photography. So the first step in order to prepare the tripod to be ready for macro photography, we gotta unscrew the weight hook at the bottom. It's just finger tight in there, so you can go ahead, you can unscrew that. Then we just got to pull the center column out of the base. So make sure that this knob is loose right there, and then just pull the rest of it out. And now we can go ahead and insert it back from the bottom, and then we'll get our camera put on and we're ready to use this for macro photography too. So let's go ahead, let's put the camera on really quick with our quick release plate. So we can go ahead, we can put that on again, tighten it down, and there we go, guys. You can see we're already ready to start using this for macro photography just like that. So look at how cool that is. You can get a lot of unique angles this way as well too if you wanted. And again, we haven't adjusted any of the legs here, so we have a lot of height to work with as well. I wanted to focus in on the adjustable leg angles again right here. It's really a great design. You just push it out from you, and now we can adjust the legs all the way up to 180 degrees. So look at that 180 degree movement that we have, and then we can just lock it back into place. So say that's as far as we want the legs to go out, we can do that right there. Or we could pull it out, lock it in again, and just keep it at a different angle. So there we go, now it's locked into right there, and we can do that for all of the legs. You can see that one's locked right there. We can bring it out and try to lock it in place again right there. So after that though, then it'll want to keep going all the way up to there and then beyond, but you can just push it back in place at whatever angle you desire to have it in. So really nice, guys, really a cool design right there. I really like that feature. So we could fold this all the way out and flat if we wanted. So it's really great that you have so many areas to control on this tripod, again, to guarantee that you get the exact shot that you want. Also, just seeing for the first time, they got MOUNTDOG right there on this nice grip too. So that looks really cool. Love seeing their logo right there. Now we have the tripod extended all the way to 55 inches, which is more than 4.5 feet. And it's doing a nice job, very sturdy, and it looks really cool. I just like how simple, lightweight, and portable this tripod is. It's very easy to maneuver and to adjust. So I did want to show you guys too that you can remove the metal ball head in case you wanted to use it with a different item. So it does reveal a much larger threaded hole at the bottom. I believe this is going to be a 3/8 inch threaded hole in case you needed an adapter to be able to use this, but it's a really nice 360 degree ball head. Now we can use it as a monopod as well if we remove one of the legs. So you can see on the tripod now we only have two legs left. There is one leg that's unique that you can remove from it. It's the leg that you see right here, obviously, because we made it into the monopod. But if you're wondering which leg, you can just see it's the only one with the nice grip on it that I pointed out earlier that has their logo and branding. So this is really cool, guys. Don't forget we can adjust it so it can be pretty tall as well. So there it is at full length right there, being able to use it to get some great photos, pictures, videos, that sort of thing on the fly. So this is highly portable, really nice. Really like everything about this tripod, how easy it is to use and how lightweight it is. Perfect if you're gonna do some quick vlogging, you're an on-the-go filmmaker, that sort of thing, you do a YouTube channel, you definitely want to consider a tripod that's as versatile as this to give you the monopod functionality and the full-fledged tripod features as well. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you guys. Be sure to hit that like button for me and subscribe to my channel. If you're interested in this product, don't forget the link to it is in my video description below. Please go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from that link. Give us a follow online too, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. You can message us on WeChat. Check out our website, join our free newsletter, follow us on Twitch, and join our Discord server as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget, we have new content daily, and we can't wait to see you in our next video.